I had this opportunity before I went on vacation to celebrate that 75th wedding anniversary. What I do at my St. Mike Parish is what I do for the couples at Senior Star. Whenever someone celebrates a milestone anniversary, 10, 25, 50, 60, we have everybody in our parish each month stand up for wedding blessings. Our bishop had made a point of reinforcing the sacredness of a wedding couple being a model of what Christ did on the cross. And so I celebrated that wedding for John and Lucille. I gave them a papal blessing. And when I went on vacation, 2 weeks later, John passed away. Family comes to me and I said to them, I feel so badly for you that this has happened. They said, no. They said, our father had enough energy to stay alive, to be with his wife because he loved her so much and we wanted this. And then a year later, as I was coming back from the doctors, they called me again and said, Mom is not doing well. Can you go visit her? And so I drove from the doctor's office in Melrose Park in Chicago, and I drove to Romeoville. I anointed her. I said, what are the doctors saying? And they said, it could be a week, it could be a month. And she passed away that night. It's a sign of God's blessing that we remember these couples. I just received an email just before we got here from a man named Dave Cook in Atlanta, Georgia. Him and his wife, his brother John and his wife, have both been married for 50 years. Both Dave and his brother are not doing well right now. And they very much ask for God's blessing. And I said to them, and I said to our parish married couples, and I say to you, when I came here today, I will remember in spirit all those who have asked me for prayers and blessings at this time. And so the couples that are about to come forward are a symbol of all the other couples who are not here at our parish and in the communities which I serve. You are reminders of what sacred thing we are about to do right now. That vow, that promise you've offered to each other, that reflects Christ's promise on the cross. Let's pray for these couples. Let's pray for all those who are married. Let's ask God to bless them and to be with them and to walk with them all the days of their life. This is our prayer. And so at this time, what I'd like to do is I'd like to call each of our couples who are here with us on this pilgrimage to come forward, and I think Cece's going to line you up as you come forward. I'd ask you to come to the front, bow to the altar, and then take your place where Cece asks you to stand so that we can offer a special blessing for you and a special blessing for all those couples, all those people who have brought their wedding rings on this special occasion. We start with Michael and Anna Marie Nuzzo, who have been married for 21 years, July 6, 1996. Dean F. and Patricia A. Buchholz, married 31 years, November 10, 1986. Stephen L. and Kathleen K. Dutress, married 39 years, April 2nd, 1978.
December 19, 1970. 47.
1969.
All of them just took a couple steps forward, you don't have to hug the wall.
So at this time, offer this special certificate. As we offer this special service, I ask the husbands and wives to turn to each other, to join hands, and to renew the covenant which you made on the day of the wedding. So husbands, I ask you to repeat after me. I renew and reaffirm.
I renew and reaffirm.
My wedding vows to you.
My wedding vows to you.
Once again, I promise.
Once again, I promise.
To love and honor you.
To love and honor you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Dear wives, I ask you to repeat after me. I renew and reaffirm.
I renew and reaffirm.
My wedding vows to you.
My wedding vows to you.
Once again, I promise.
Once again, I promise.
To love and honor you.
To love and honor you.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
All the days of my life. You have your ring. All of you who have brought your rings with you, please get them out. If you have any other articles you would like blessed at this time, I'll do that as well. And so we pray. Lord, increase and consecrate the love which these married couples have for one another. The wedding rings they once exchanged are the sign of their fidelity. May they continue to prosper in the grace of the sacrament. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like you to touch your wives' rings or hold your wives' rings and repeat after me. Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father and of the Son
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. So if they still fit, you can place them on their ring. All right, wives, repeat after me as you touch your husband's ring. Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, there is a special custom that we have. Well, first of all, let's pray the words our Lord has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen. There's a custom that we have whenever we offer it. Marriage liturgy or renewal of vows, and we offer a special prayer called a nuptial blessing where we ask God to impart his love on those who have come before us. I invite you to join me in this blessing. If you would please do me a favor, except for all of you, extend your hands out to the couples in front of us and ask God to bless them all the days of their life. Almighty eternal God, you have so exalted the unbreakable bond of marriage that it has become the sacramental sign of your Son's union with the church as his spouse. Look with favor on this married couple whom you have united in marriage. as they ask, continue to ask for your help and protection of the Virgin Mary. They pray that in good times and in bad, they will grow for their love of one another, that they will resolve to be of one heart and bond in peace. Bless also those married couples who cannot be together here yet today. Increase their love for each other as well. Comfort and console those whose spouses have died with the sure and certain knowledge that love is eternal, and they will be together again in heaven, where all are made one in you. Bless the couples who are not here today in our home respective parishes, that God may continue to be with them and walk with them on their journey. Lord, in their struggles, let them rejoice when you are near to help them. In their needs, let them know that you are there to rescue them. In their joys, let them see that you are the source and fullness of every happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless and protect and be with the couples that are with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's offer our couples a round of applause. You may kiss the bride.